Spending time in a hospital can be a bit overwhelming, even scary for an adult. So imagine what it's like for a child. That's where a child life specialist comes in. They help families and young patients during their stay here, making life at the hospital as normal as possible. We got a chance to catch up with two child life specialists and see them in action.
Do you want a warm blanket? No. No, you're warm enough? Do you want to watch a cartoon?
No.
No? You're comfy? No. Okay. What else are you going to do later today, do you think?
Go to school.
Go to school? You'll feel good enough to go to school. Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm so glad. All right. Well, if you need anything, let us know, okay?
Do you know how long the test is going to be until it comes back, or how?
Usually our tests take about 30 to 45 minutes.
Kind of depending.
Yeah, 30 to 45. Could you arrange? Because I'm never exactly sure.
Leah Thompson is a child life specialist here at Sacred Heart Children's Hospital. Thank you for being here.
Of course. Thanks for having me.
Talk about what it means to be a child life specialist.
Yeah, so as a child life specialist, our job is to work with the psychosocial and emotional aspects of hospitalized patients. So we do a lot of coping, procedural support and preparation, diagnosis education, just being an advocate for the patient and their family while they're here at the hospital.
So does that start the minute they walk in the doors?
It does. We have specialists in the pediatric emergency room, in our pediatric surgery center, in the general pediatric floor, the peds intensive care unit, peds oncology, outpatient peds oncology, and then we have a specialist who works with NICU patients and children of adult patients as well.
So it's a real team approach.
It is, yep. We all work together. We collaborate daily. We have a team huddle. We just communicate with each other and do a lot of passing off of patient reports to make sure that we are all meeting the needs of patients no matter where they are in the hospital.
Sort of walk us through the day, a typical day for you.
So for me personally, I'm on the PEDS outpatient oncology clinic. So our patients are coming in for appointments. They usually have a lab and an exam with one of our doctors. And from there, they'll either get admitted or they get to go home. But my day is spent doing distraction, procedural support, just general check-ins to make sure patients are doing well at home and kind of how they're processing and progressing throughout their diagnosis.
So what are some of the tools that you use to do that, to communicate with kids?
We do a lot of play is kind of our main thing. So whether it's medical play, making them more comfortable with whatever kind of line they have or whatever procedure they might experience. It might just be play in one of our many playrooms we have at the hospital. It could just be an art activity, utilizing some of our additional coworkers who are part of our art team. We also have programs like our Beads of Courage program that'll help encourage patients as they go along their journeys. They get a bead for every aspect of their hospitalization, whether it's a poke, whether it's a procedure, they might be sedated, it could just be an overnight stay. All of those earn them a bead. And at the end, they have these really long strings that can tell their family members, their friends, about their time at the hospital.
Oh, that's awesome. You use music therapy as well?
We do. We have a music therapist in-house, and we also have a few different organizations we partner with. So Songs for Kids is one that we work with, and they come to us every Tuesday, and they go room to room and hang out in our playrooms and common areas and take song requests from patients and families, and just bring so much light to the patients whenever they can sing to them and give them something familiar that they don't always have in the hospital.
So this is unique to a children's hospital, obviously, correct?
For the most part. Yeah. As the profession grows, it's still a newer profession, so as the profession's growing, we see it starting to expand into not only just the freestanding children's hospitals, but also children's hospitals within adult hospitals, and even out into the community, into dental offices, and some people are even opening their own private practices in child life now to accompany people to whatever kind of appointments they might have.
What kind of a difference does it make in a child's care to have a child life specialist along the way?
Yeah, I can only go off of experiences that I've heard from families, but they just have nothing but great things to say about how much it's helped their child, or their child might come to the hospital for the first time screaming or just unsure of what's happening, and we're there to explain things to them in language that they understand, and to be a fun, friendly face that they can see as a supporter and a friend that'll help encourage them to overcome whatever obstacle they might face, and to just be there to advocate for whatever needs we foresee them having while they're with us.
Mm-hmm. Part of your job is sort of making that process normal, if you will. So I know you also plan parties for the kids and special events as well.
We do, yeah, with the holidays. We always have something fun going on. We do random days throughout the year, just those daily holidays, like today's donut day, so we'll bring donuts to the families, or we just recently did, it was bee day, so we had lots of fun bee crafts, so just fun things to make the hospital a less scary place and to kind of normalize the environment for them so it's not seen as this awful place where scary things happen, but it's okay, I know I can go there, and there's people there who care about me and want to support me and help me out.
Mm-hmm. Do you get kids coming back and wanting to see you even after their treatment?
We do, yeah, they always are. Or if they go to a different unit, they're like, oh, but I want to go back because so-and-so works on this unit, and I want to see them because they helped me so much when I was here. And
because it's a fairly new specialty, do you need more child life specialists?
I think as the profession grows, and I think as children's hospitals expand and there's a greater need for certain services, I think we would love to see this hospital have a specialist 24/7 to help the patients who come to the ER at all hours of the day, or patients who might have an unexpected procedure, to be there to support them and help them navigate that uncharted territory.
Is there a typical education path toward this?
Yes and no. I think everyone's journey is a little bit different, but for the most part, we see people who have a child development background, child psychology, anyone who's kind of in that helping field. There are certain classes that are necessary to become certified as a specialist, and you have to complete a practicum and an internship before you can even sit for the exam. So once those coursework classes are completed, then you can become a certified child life specialist. So the whole process can take anywhere from a few years post undergrad or included in your undergrad with a little extra work.
And a love for kids?
Always a love for kids. You have to be a very patient person and someone who is willing to dedicate their time and just has a passion for helping children grow and develop.
Leah, thank you so much for telling us more about being a child life specialist and the work that you do here at Sacred Heart Children's Hospital.
Thank you.
Thank you.